Greetings and thank you for tuning in to the Filling Station. Take a journey with us as we walk through the Word. Tune in and be blessed.
Somebody in my said, you know, his stepmother has dealing with cancerous cells that are traveling around in her body, because that's all cancer does. It begins to travel. We give way to it when we start to worry and when we get angry and all these kinds of things. But how many? It's another cancer that we have called sin. I'm saying something right there. Yeah. And we don't allow the worship service to heal the cancerous. Oh my God. We don't allow that worship service to heal the cancerous cells. And so that's why when we come to church, we keep doing the same thing. As soon as we leave the church, we got the same mindset that we came in, because we don't allow the worship service to heal the cancer cells. So I said to the Lord after we talked, I said, you know, our worship service can heal. Sometimes people don't really want to be healed.
Yeah.
Sometimes people really don't want to be healed, because, you know, when your flesh wakes up and likes stuff, it's not going back to sleep until you decide that I'm going to put it to rest.
Yeah.
I'm going to kill it. I'm going to starve it. We got to learn how to starve our flesh. I ain't talking about just pushing it back your plate. I'm talking about the thing you like to touch that you're not supposed to. Come on, oh my God. He said it has to start with you first. That's why we take worship leaders for granted, and they take themselves for granted, because you have to heal. Worship is healing. It heals cancer. It heals. The song she says, fill me up, she says, till I overflow, as I want to run over. Come on, this is what the Lord was saying to me last night, just by the comment I made to him. He said they can be healed in a worship service.
Yeah. Yeah.
We don't know we can be healed in a worship. We don't look for the healing in the worship service. We look for the healing in another. We look for altar call. Come on.
Yeah. Come on.
Healing services happens right at worship.
Yeah.
That's why you don't have time to be playing with the worship leader with the filthy lifestyle. Oh my God. So when you have a filthy lifestyle, what are you going to give to the people? How are you going to lead me? In a dirty road. Come on. To check ourselves. Come on, let's sing this song. Now I told you what it means. You provide fire.
Thank you.
flow.
This should be a part of your heart.
I want to run. Oh.
This should be a part of your heart right now.
Spirit's free.
said there's a healing anointing.
Till I overflow.
He said it would be
healing.
Come unto me, all of you who are weary.
till I overflow.
See, we got to provide the sacrifice. God always provides the fire. He always provides the fire. He always makes a way of escape.
Fill me up.
He makes a way to fill you. Keep you on fire.
Till I overflow.
Well, let's listen to go with the Spirit.
I wanna run over.
because the dancers wait till Sunday to get filled up. You keep worshiping dancers. You can take the rebuke while you worship. The worship will make you feel that.
Feel me.
The dancers wait till Sunday to come get filled up. We're waiting for their wings to flap that the Lord has given them to grace us with the glory of the Lord. They wait till they come here to sing songs of Zion with us. Last week I told you the hardest thing to be right now is a what?
Christian.
A Christian. Hardest thing to do right now is to live holy, upright, and saved. I struggle too, so I'm not above that. I'm not an exception to the rule. But when God has given you something for the body of Christ, you should be a gift and not a hindrance. And when dancers don't move their limbs, do you think that's a hindrance to the kingdom?
Yeah.
It's a hindrance to our worship, sir. Well, it tries to be. The devil is a liar. Do we need them?
Yes.
I can see a leg flying in the air right now. And an arm flapping right in there. I can see that in my spirit. I wish I could see that in the natural. Got to get it together, dancers. You get lost in worship with us. We waiting on y'all. Waiting on y'all. See, God is not going to bless. He got to get this core right. Come on, that's why I don't worry about it. We got the core, got money. We not broke. Come on, we brought bank accounts running over. Come on, I believe that in my spirit. We're going to see that with our eyes. When God has given you a gift and you become a hindrance, you better watch yourself. He's not pleased with that. Gave you a gift that you can be a blessing to the body, not so you can be prideful and not use it. They say if you don't use it, you'll lose it. I don't believe that. I've never seen that to be true, because he said the gifts and the callings come without repentance, so they're going to stay with you. It's up to you how you decide to use your gift and honor God. And that's where I'm going, dancers. You need to learn to honor God with your body. Not this other stuff that you, the hardest thing to do right now is to live upright. I was looking at something last night. In fact, he told me I was one of the last of the Mohicans. And you've heard me say that before. That's not cute. That's not funny to me. I'm not like, oh my God. No, do you know how difficult that could be? Because when you say yes to God, and he said you one of the last of the ones that's going to be standing up, and I'm 40 years old, come on. That's the, I said, God, that frightens me. Why I have to be filled up till I overflow, so I can run over and do what he's requiring. Do you understand what he's requiring from you, son? Do you want this to come on? Because see, you got to provide the sacrifice for him. He always provides the fun. We got to learn how to provide the sacrifices, gifts. We don't provide the sac. You are the sacrifice. What do you do? You do what you want to do with this sacrifice. You gotta learn. This does not belong to you. It's the hardest thing to get rid of. It's your flesh. It's the heart, because it's never gonna go away until you die. Come on, we got to keep it so 100 right in here. It's the hardest thing to do is get rid of your flesh. Because Eve had the devil awaken those 5 senses. Then the Holy Ghost came and gave you a 6th sense.
Yeah. Come on.
6th sense, wake up. Wake up.
The name of Jesus.
6th sense, wake up. Body's waiting for you. And the thing I like about God is he said, I put somebody else in your blood. I raise somebody else up. When he does that, that means he disappoints. I don't want him disappointed in me. Did you want him disappointed in you?
No.
Wake up. We can't let the rivers of our worship flow to him. We're not worshiping. Can't let it happen if we're not. Come on. The worship service is for healing. Praise and worship is for healing. That's the one thing that they tried to take away from the church. That's why I wanted you to get this. That's the one thing they tried. Well, you know, y'all ain't got about 10 minutes. The choir got about 5 minutes. But the preacher ain't saying nothing.
Come on.
Preacher ain't saying nothing. So I'm expecting to get my blessing in praise and worship. The choir is all tore up. We wear what we want to wear. Skirt short.
People come to church looking for healing and worship. They come to church looking for that one song. That's the one I like.
Yeah.
Because there's healing there. So we bind the devil of time that wants to break back the worship and the praise in our services. Let the musicians play. Let the drums prophesy. Come on. But the gifters have to be anointed. Not just a gift. Come on, that's we sit there and we can look at that on So You Think You Can Dance. They all that talented. We need to see the gift practice per the anointing. Come on, I'm saying something right in here. We make a mistake. The choir don't even march in no more. Remember when the choir used to march in with their robes? Anointed vessels, anointed garments, marching in. Come on, blessing the people. We say, oh, that take too much time. I was listening to a song by Timothy Wright yesterday. We used to sing it when I was younger. Magnify him, come on, magnify him. We don't sing songs of Zion like that no more. All those giants are dead in the ground, and we're not even writing songs like that no more. Come on! We're not even writing songs like that no more. We got a beat to it so people can bow their head. That's not it. That's not real worship. God said, that's not real worship. And that's not the praise that I want. Not the praise, that's not the worship that I need cancer to be drawn up in a worship service. I need you to be able to invite somebody to church and worship changes their lives.
Come on,
a skip and a hop and an anointed dance will change the trajectory of their walk in Christ. Come on, we don't do it like that no more. I have noticed the church next door, and God forgive them if they hear me, I don't care, but they're singing other people's songs. And they're trying to make it that that's not it. I want to talk to the man. Sing in your native tongue, period. Leave Hillside alone. Hillsong. Sing in your native tongue before the Lord. And I guarantee you the glory of the Lord will fall. It's not going to fall like it falls in a Hillsong concert because you're not Hillsong. God is calling us to a deeper place. He's calling Zion to a higher place of praise. Got to get anointed. Don't wait to come in here and worship with us. We're expecting you to take us to another level. Come on. But where you at? So that's why they was over there singing so hard. Because that's what they need. They need to run over. See? They've got to run over with worship and praise. We can't wait to how many honored the fast last week, the Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday? Just be honest, you don't have to lie in his presence. It's all right. You ain't got to lie in his presence. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. God said, we have been released from that. I said, God, are you sure? I asked him every hour, God, are you sure? God, we could keep going. He said, you've been released from that. He said, you did. This is your last week. I said, okay, God. Told me to tell some of you that you have not been released in your spirit. You need to continue on with your fast. And he's going to honor it. He's going to honor it. He said, I'm going to honor it. You haven't been released in your spirit. God has taken you somewhere where he may not be taking us, and that's all right with me. We need to keep going. And the dancers need to understand that they are give to the body of Christ. And the anointing needs to rest upon you. It needs to just, see how this jacket, it needs to just wear. It's not resting. It's not there. How do you get it back? Worship. Now when you come in here, because we don't need to see you fall on the ground. We need to see if you take us to another level. Come on. Get it together. Lift your hearts to God. You need to ask him right now, God, help me get it together. See, you are a gift to the body. See, I know that I can feel that he knows exactly what I'm saying, because you know what it's like to be a gift to the body. you know what it's like to be, you know what it's like for them to call you all the time. Can you do, can you come, can you come? See, we take that kind of stuff for granted when we gifts. Some stuff that you need to say no to, but some things that you need to agree to because the Lord says so. You don't let people pimp you out now. So all money ain't good money. All payments ain't good payments. All checks ain't good checks. Whether they bounce or not, it's not a good, come on, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying when God calls you, you need to be ready. If he calls you to London right now, neither one of y'all are ready to go. I love you today, but neither one of you are ready to go. If they called you to do a praise and worship symposium for dancers, neither one of you are ready to do it. You need to be that ready is what I'm saying. You need to be that ready is what I'm saying. He said, if you be faithful over a few things, I'll bless you.
Over many.
That's what he said. That's what he said. The word network's called, you think I'm ready to go? I'm ready.
Yes.
I aspire to be ready. I have to keep my life clean. I have to keep my life together. I have to do that. You know how difficult that could be. So come on, I'm keeping it real with you. Do you know how difficult that could be sometimes? Your yes is very hard to get out. You have to do it. I'm telling you what I know to be true. That's why I get shared that with y'all. I have to give up your yes. Not just today, not just in this hour, but at 2 o'clock too. At 3 o'clock too. Amen. You have to give him your yes. Anoint you with oil from heaven. That's
flow to you.
Something happening in the spirit.
Let all my worship.
worship, come on. Let all my praise flow to you. Flow to you.
That's the part I say.
Let all my worship, let all my praise flow to you. Flow to you.
That's the part that gives me the victory.
Let all my worship, let all my praise flow to you.
Can y'all hear the dancers? Come on.
Flow to you.
Come on, I see it. I see it in my spirit.
Let all my worship, let all my praise flow to you.
Say
flow. Let all my worship,
oh, this is where you'll hear the
let, all my praise,
let all my praise
flow to you, flow to you. Let all my worship, let all my praise flow to you, flow. Let all my praise flow to you, flow to you. Let all my worship, let all my praise flow to you, flow to you.
See, this man right here doesn't get a chance to do what he's doing right now in his church.
Let all my worship, let all my praise flow to you, flow to you.
I wish the dancers would just get up and move. That's the healing now.
Let all my worship,
I wish they would stop watching us. Let all, I'm thinking about us watching now.
Flow to you.
I wish they would just move those limbs.
Cast completely by
sight.
Come on.
Let all my praise flow to you.
Come on, don't let it go nowhere else, God. Don't filter me out.
Let all my worship,
all my praise, everything I've got,
let all my praise flow to you.
All of my worship and all of my praise.
Let all my worship, let all my praise flow to you. Flow to you. Let all my worship, let all my praise flow.
Bocos cadibando Right where you want us to be.
Catarlibi Sandorobosi.
Oh,
multiply.
It's not for you to have kids, brother. That's not the entailment.
Come on.
That's not the whole intent. Be fruitful and multiply. Come consummate with me, so I can drop the seed. Impregnate you with my glory. Grow in you, and you can deliver. Church is for. That's what the real church is designed for. It's not designed to meet your friends and have coffee with your men. That's not what it's about. It's about the consummation.
Yeah.
If you don't go to church and you don't get pregnant, then you need to go somewhere else. So somewhere you can get pregnant.
Okay.
Somewhere where you got to go in further. Come on.
But check this out. Even if your womb is shut up, he'll open it up. Come on.
Come on.
So says the word of God. You got to get back to your first love. Because see, when you love somebody, then you can consummate with them. Prostitutes consummate with anybody.
Right. Okay.
When you and there's no impregnate, come on, there's no seed. There may be some semen, but there's no seed. Well, yeah, see, we got to talk real talk. But when you come into the house of the Lord, he's the lover of your soul. You love him, he loves you. As no, you used to be in touch like that right there. Come on. So then when he begins to drop the seed off in you, he can grow. His glory can grow in you. So when we say, fill me up till I overflow, when the baby is born, everybody can see the vision that he is birthed in you. Come on. That's what church is for. Get your offering together. It's another way you can consummate. Fall in love. We're not a broke ministry, so you know that's not it. The past works, come on. Amen. I'm just saying because you know we have to break that barrier sometimes. We really do. We have to break that. We give money to all other stuff. Now y'all know I've been in love with Corrales for about three weeks now. <laughs> They ready though. They ready. Ready to go today. Give me some of the herbs and bread, but don't nobody want to go with me. It's all right.
Go find me some kind of meal or grain offering to offer up to the Lord.
So I want him to be satisfied. I want him to come. Fill me up, God, to overflow.
She crazy.
That's his name. The Lord, I was looking at it yesterday, how I was just wondering, you know, when you have money, everybody got their income tax and stuff. Or if you got money, you just want to spend it. Just your whole just pocket just burn it.
Mm-hmm.
Train yourself.
Yeah.
You got to train yourself. Even if it's not just about tithes, you can't just be spending money. You got to have some money set aside.
Yeah.
Best believe it's gonna rain.
Oh yeah.
The seasons just rain comes in the seasons. So we want to give of what the Lord has given us. I want you to know that next month marks the whole month of our first fruit offering.
Woo 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 woo!
I should have said something. God is going to give you what you need to give. He's going to give you that. And you need to listen to that. And you need to obey that. You need to obey that. God is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him, even in their money. I was looking through my book, and it said that the last time we did was March 15th. But God told me, was it last week or week before last? Whenever. He said that the whole month of March is sowing season. Come on, that thing, y'all should have been excited about that. He said that's sowing time. And in the Bible, they did first fruits twice a year because they did it at springtime and they did it again at harvest. They gave back what they got at harvest. So they did it twice. So we need to be cognizant of the harvest. Because your harvest, come on, when you plant celery root, it grows already. Y'all,
right.
When you put the celery seeds in the ground, it begins to grow. You put the water on it, bloop, bloop, bloop. Some seeds that you put in the ground will grow right away. Now, if you mess them with some potatoes, you're going to have to wait a minute.
Right, just got to germinate.
Mess with a couple of apples, you may need to wait a minute. Amen? If you mess them with some trees or something, you can see a return, an immediate return begins to take root. So you need to know what you're sowing seed. And how many believe this is good ground?
Yeah. Amen.
You got to believe. Thanks so much. But I did feel it in my spirit on today. So, come on. But we're sowing into good ground, and you need to understand that this is the ground that you're sowing on. Amen. Well, give the Lord a hand praise while you wait for directions to sow. And let me tell you, let me help you out right here with your sowing. You know, that Starbucks drink that you want, this $4.80, come on, that grande. Caramel macchiato, extra hot. Come on, I know what I like. And it's $4.80. And I go the other way because I know what I have to do. I know what I want to do. And I know I'm in house hunting. I'm house hunting right now. Amen. You all praise God for me. You ain't coming over for dinner. But God has said, come on, I won't cook. I won't serve you. I won't.
It's not your
sin. It's not your sin. Come on. That was a different time. A man probably not just to praise.
Come on.
But God, we put praise on my house. Come on. So, but because I know what I have to do, because I know what kind of money I have to have in the bank, I can't go to buy $4 eggs and drink. Mm-hmm. Got to go to the house and get that Kroger Columbia. Come on.
Come on. Put you some ice on it.
So you got to come on. I'm saying you have to use wisdom with our money. Is what I'm saying. You got to use wisdom with our money. Amen. So. God lives in your spirit, son, because I can see it in your spirit. You want to bless the gifts and the gift givers. God, we thank you for the gifts and the gift givers. God, give us a clear, concise understanding what it means to be a tither, what it means to be an offering giver, what it means to hold up a grain or a wave offering to you, God, a sin offering or a drink offering. Give us a full understanding, oh God. Bring it to the forefront so that we would never steer wrong. In Jesus' name, we thank you. We give you praise.
He has raised us, so to God be the glory for all the things that He has done.
Come on, I want you to get that with this love. Come on, with His love, what has He done for you?
He has saved.
Worship. I was up at 2 o'clock in the morning worshiping God, and He said, today is purposeful worship. And I said, Lord, I said, I've been studying and I got a word. He said, they don't need to hear the word. They done heard the word. They need to hear me in their hearts. So let's just lift our hands today. We already got hijacked. So Pastor was in the same vein. But there's something else that God wants to do for you. He wants to change who you are. How many want to be changed? Let's not just raise our hands and raise our hearts just because we got the cliche gifts. But we're talking about a real change. We're talking about a change that when you hear certain things, it just triggers you right to God. Come on. I was watching the Passion of the Christ footage when they was beating Jesus. And about 3 lashes in, I had to turn it off. Because He said, I did that for y'all. I did that for you. It was unbearable for me to finish watching that. How many of you have seen that movie? I've seen the movie, watched it a few times. And in certain parts that stopped. But when I was looking at the beating, I was reminded of Isaiah 53. We quote that part all the time. He's beaten for our transgressions. Come on, let's go to 53. Isaiah 53. Oh, y'all can just keep worshiping. I'm going to just get there. Because I got to read this, because we don't read the whole chapter. We just read what we want people to hear. We just read what we want people to hear, and we want to keep it cliche. But if they read the whole chapter, they'll know. If they read the whole chapter, they would know. Keep singing that to God be glory. He says, who believed our report? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? Come on, there's a build up to this. He shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of dry ground. He has no form of comeliness, and when we see him, there is no beauty. Come on, that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. Come on, we usually skip this part and go, he was bruised. No. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we do not esteem him. Surely he was born of our griefs,
and carried our sorrows. Yet we esteem him stricken, smitten by God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgression. Come on, this is the popular part. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his stripes we are healed. We don't believe that we can be healed. That's why God came today to heal us. I can show you my healing. I can show you my healing. I can show you my healing. And we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted. Yet he opened not his mouth. And he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before it sheared in silence. So he opened not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment. And who will declare his generation? For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgression of my people he was stricken, and they made his grave with the wicked. But with the rich at his death, because he had done no violence, nor was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. Come on. He put him to grief. When you make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. He shall see the labor of his soul and be satisfied. By his knowledge, my righteous servant shall justify many. And for he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore I will divide him a portion with the great. And he shall divide the spoil with the strong. And he will pour out his soul unto death. Come on, pour out his soul unto death. And he was numbered with the transgressors. He was born of sin. He bore the sin of many, and he made intercession for the transgression. Come on, we don't read all that. We just get to the part he was bruised, but they don't really show everything that he went through. He wants us to worship him, but in order to worship him, you have to know who he is. You have to know what he did. He told me, he said, tell him about my miracles. And I was like, God, I always talk about the same ones. And he was like, no, I'm going to show you a different one. He's like, what about the man that was born blind? Come on. We don't see miracles like this because nobody's willing to sacrifice and worship and praise. Nobody's willing to sacrifice and lay down that life. Spit in the clay. Spit in the ground and made clay and rubbed it on his eyes. Told him to go wash your face. Go wash your eyes. When he washed his eyes, the man could see. When he washed his eyes, the man could see. And then the man was before the Philistines. Come on. I mean, before the Pharisees and Sadducees. And they was like, who opened up your eyes? This is in John chapter 9. So if y'all want to go read it, go read it. He said, who opened up your eyes? We do not know him. We do not know him. Come on. Who opened up your eyes? He told him, it's a man. Told him what happened. Let's go to John 9. Come on, I want to read it to you real quick, and then we'll be done. We'll be done. How many enjoyed the worship?
Yes.
But I want you to see this miracle so that it can change your life and that you can see. I read Isaiah 53 all the time. Because it's so close and near to my heart. So if we go to 53, John 9, and let's just jump to 15. Then the Pharisees asked him how he had received his sight. And he said to them, he put clay on my eyes and I washed and I can see. Therefore, some of the Pharisees said, this man is not from God because he does not keep the Sabbath. Come on, he got healed on the Sabbath day. Jesus didn't care about no Sabbath day. He was just like, this man needs to be healed. Come on, this man needs to be healed. And he says, therefore, others said, how can a man who is a sinner do such signs? Come on, the Pharisees was on one. I'm telling y'all, if y'all read it, you'll see. They had some stuff going on. There was a division amongst them. Then he said to the blind man, "What do you say about him because he opened your eyes?" He said, "He is a prophet." But the Jews did not believe concerning him that he had been blind and received his sight. So I'm not going to read the rest of it. The Jews didn't believe that this man was born blind. They, no, you wasn't born blind. So they went and called his mama and his daddy. And they said, "We know this to be our son, and he was born blind." Come on, other people, if you go earlier into the chapter, other people knew that he was blind because he was begging for money in front of the church. Couldn't see. And they said, "Is that not the man that was blind yesterday?" Come on. He can see today.
Yesterday.
He can see today. Because he asked me for some quarters yesterday, and I knew that he couldn't see me. But now, he can see me. Come on. And then the parents said, "He's old enough. Why don't you ask him if he was born blind? What you call us for? What you call us for?" So they called him again, and he said to them, "Give God the glory. We know that this man is a sinner." He answered and said, "Whether he is a sinner or not, I don't know. One thing that I do know is that I was blind, and now I can see."
Yeah.
Come on. This is who we worship. Then they said to him again, "What did he do? How did he open your eyes?" And then I bet you was mad at this point because he said, "Now I done told you, but you didn't listen." Come on, you didn't listen. Now if we jump down to verse 30, the man answered to them and said,
"Okay.
Why, this is a marvelous thing that you do not know where he is from, yet he has opened my eyes. Now we know that God does not hear sinners, but if anyone is a worshiper of God," mm-hmm. come on, that's the part I like, "and does his will, he hears him." Come on, don't you want him to hear you today? Since the world began, it has been unheard of that anyone opened the eyes of one who was born blind. If this man were not from God, he could do nothing. They answered and said to him, "You were completely born in sins, and you are teaching to us." And they cast him out. Come on, he got touched by God and had a wisdom by it. And he started preaching to them right there. And they were just like, "Well, you were a sinner. You can't preach to us. We the Pharisees, we the Sadducees." Come on, that's how we act sometimes. When the package ain't right. We want to drop somebody down and be like, "Well, you know, you look like you fresh out the club. You look like you fresh off the streets. God ain't speaking to you. Get on out of here." Come on.
We do that as
Christians. And that's why the next verses say true vision and true blindness. Come on. They told the man that, "Are you his disciple? Because we're disciples of Moses. We don't know who he is." That's why they couldn't worship and praise God for the victory that this man had. But we can. Now, today's whole purpose was for worship. Today's whole purpose was for to change your life. To change your life. And you have to take what we had today and get it again at home. But it's going to be different because it's going to be personalized.
Right.
It's going to be personalized. I'm telling you, this whole time that I was fasting, it was personalized for me. Not saying that I didn't worship before, but this was a different type of worship. It was life-changing, altering worship. Come on. Where you're driving and you got to pull over because you can't see worship. Where you get home and just lay out because you got to just worship. Come on, that's where he wants us to be, because then he can give you your melodies. He can give you your songs because you sing them to him. He can give you your creative ideas. You can dance before him and let the oil pour out on you so that you can bring it here. Amen. So let's not lose what we captured today. Wasn't it wonderful? It was different, wasn't it? It was different. It was new. It was something that can change who you are. It's something that will change who you are, because it changed me. Because I was like, "God, I know." Come on. I need to be changed. Come on, Justin, let's play this song. The Hill. And we're going to end it with that. Mm-hmm. by Travis Green. See, I'm just going to jump to this part because this part right here blessed my spirit. He goes, bloody and beautiful. Bloody and beautiful. And one of his performances, he said, he changed it up and then he said, messy with miracles. On the bloody and beautiful. This is how it goes. On the hill, there's a cross. On the cross, there is blood for. On a hill, there's a cross. On the cross, there is blood for me. Come on. On a hill, there's a cross. On the cross, there is blood for me. Uncomfortable. It made me check who I was because I said, God, I can do more than what I'm doing now. See, when we see his perfection, we see our mess. When we see his sacrifice, we see how lazy we are. Come on, the Bible says that there was not a word in his mouth. There was not a word in his mouth when he took the beating. They switched between sticks and whips. And they laughed and they mocked him. They put a crown on his head and they slapped him with a board. There's a cross. On the cross, there is blood for me. Let's lift our hearts in worship. On the hill, there's a cross. On the cross, there is blood for me. It goes on in the song, say, there's blood for you too. On the hill, there's a cross. On the cross, there is blood for me. For me.
On the messy with miracle heal. On the bloody and beautiful heal.
Reach the heel and get the blood for you.
On the beauty and bloody heal.
He said the cross, and he goes on and says, the cross don't discriminate. Cross don't discriminate on the beauty and blood. Oh, we thank you, Jesus.
On the hill there's a cross. On the cross there is blood for on the hill there is a cross. On the cross there is blood for me. On the hill there's a cross. On the cross there is blood for on the beauty. On the beauty of the hill there's a cross. On the cross there's a blood for me. For
how many want to allow the worship this week to change your life?
Wonderful.
Yes. To heal our diseases.
How many gonna let worship change your life? How many gonna let praise change your life this week? Just take out some time. Just take out some time so that you can want to see the miracles. Come on, don't we want to be a difference in the land? Don't we want to walk into a room and say, be free because the Lord sets you free? And sing this song to them and let them know that there's blood on the hill. To heal their diseases and to cover their weakness.
It still has the power, wonderful power, to heal our diseases on the bloody beautiful
hill. If you just think about the bloody beautiful. When he got to the hill, he was still bleeding. There was still a trail on his way there. And when they lifted him up, the blood ran down the cross on the front and the back side. And he said not one word. he was thinking about us. He was thinking about us in the street. He was thinking about us out there doing drugs and getting drunk. He was thinking about how he was dying for that purpose. He was dying for our sins. He was dying for our iniquity. He was dying for our minds. He was dying for the things that keep us away from him. He said that he has afforded us the opportunity. This is another step to that afforded us the opportunity. It requires a deeper sacrifice. Come on, sis said that we are the sacrifice. Yeah. We have to become the sacrifice throughout the week, not just on Sundays. Not just on Sundays. So that we can lay out on the floor like she is with somebody who needs help. Come on. So we can lay out at the house because we need help. Come on, how many need help? I know I need help every second. Man, because I know how I think. Especially when I get in certain situations, my mind goes different places. We have to be real with ourselves. See, that's what they don't teach. We do here, but that's what they don't teach at other places. They would just read the Bible and just pray. No. You need to be real about situations and deal with yourself. And worship changes who you are. Oh, hallelujah. It changes who you are. I'm serious. I'm so excited about this because it took my worship to another level. This is something that I didn't realize. It was just cliche for me to worship. Just worship and pray, because I'm big on prayer. Big on prayer. Just pray. But I would always leave out the worship aspect. And you know, God kept trying to creep in and say, Brian, do this. And I would just do a little bit. But then I just yielded myself during this fast. See, that's when yield yourself to what God is trying to do. I was like, God, okay, you're trying to do something new because this is different to me. So you got to see what he's trying to do for you and yield to it. Worship will get you there. Got you there today, man. That's it. Good. We done got hijacked the whole service. It's almost 1 o'clock.
Oh, I thought you were talking to the person. Amen. Amen. So this shit was all with me. Is it him?
We encourage you to continue to tune in regularly. And if you are in the Las Vegas Valley, join us at the YMCA located at 4141 Meadows Lane, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89107. Meet us there every Sunday morning at 10:30 a.m. As well, like us on Facebook and tune in to our podcast on iHeartRadio. If you are in need of special prayer, please email us at thefillingstationlv@gmail.com. We will be glad to labor with you until God offers a resolve. You can also sow a seed into this ministry by giving online through PayPal. Sow all seeds to thefillingstationlv@gmail.com. Expect a harvest. Be blessed.